This painting is called It Came From Beneath Space. It was completed in 1993. Okay. What this is about is essentially an exercise in lucid dreaming. This is for my lucid dream sequence. This is lucid dream number 52. Dream Friday, December 20th, 1991, between 1:37 a.m. and 3:05 a.m., 88 minutes from the second REM cycle. That was on an anniversary of my father's birth. But it's about my mother, which is interesting, that in a sense I got both parents involved in this. Now, for those who don't know anything about lucid dreaming, which is probably about three people left on the planet at this time, that it means that you are able to know that you are dreaming while the dreaming is going on. It's literally entering the white light of the tupoidal aspect of your mind directly. In other words, it's as close as most people ever come to creating a tulpa. Because like a normal dream, it's affecting you. And you think that this is a hallucination, because when you wake up and you say, well, I've had this hallucination. I thought reality was like that for a moment or two, for however how long your dream lasted. Now, when you do lucid dreaming, and you have a sense of what that is, you literally feel that you are in control of the dream sequence. So you're getting the sense of how a tulpa acts in the way that you can control it. So this is almost like in Hebrew mythology, the golem. In other words, where you put the letters on the forehead of say Yahweh, like that, and the lump of clay gets up and does your bidding. Okay, well that when you're looking at the imagery in the lucid dream, you can literally manipulate the scenes and the props and the characters, but there is still an invariance left. There is still a spatial part of it left, so that it's a dialogue between you and the dream stuff. So it is not yet a total tulpa, where you are in total control of it. That's in a different situation. But it's such an interesting experience to most people that it deserves to be recorded. So this whole exercise, in other words, moves beyond say like surrealism, which dealt with dreams. Maybe to some extent that it got into lucid dreaming, but not very much. In other words, it kept the idea that the subconscious was some kind of a scientific construct, like André Breton eventually became so ideologically bound that he would not allow people into surrealism unless they believed in a Freudian definition of the subconscious. You know, which is crazy, because the subconscious isn't any place. It can't be defined by anybody. It can only be hinted at. I would say that Jung made more fruitful hints about its nature than Freud. And so we can actually find through lucid dreaming, you know, say like the difference between the wakescape and the dreamscape.